Good evening everyone. Today we are going to study types of compounds. This topic falls under morphology. So let's just start with the topic. So compounding is basically one of the word formation processes. With the help of compounding we make new words. So words are formed by already existing words, means they are two or more words joined together to make one longer word. For example, we have houseboat, outhouse, and we, in our surrounding we find a lot of compound words. Compound words are basically formed by two elements, we can say. Sometimes as we are going to discuss types of compounds, we will see that in some types both the elements are present, while in some other types only one element is present. Okay, so these two elements are head and the modifier. So head is the one that contains the basic meaning of the compound, while modifier is something that restricts this meaning. That means it modifies the head and it restricts the meaning of the head. So taking these basic things into mind, let's just start with the types of compounds. So the first distinction is between endocentric compounds and exocentric compounds. So in all the types, we are supposing that AB is a compound, and A and B are two different words here. Let's just start with endocentric compounds. Here A plus B means the two words is a denotes a special kind of B, means it modifies the B. A modifies the B. B is the head here and A is the modifier. Endocentric compounds, in endocentric compounds means head is present in it. It is semantically headed compound. Here the POS or part of speech of the compound will be determined by that of head. Means what will be the part of speech of the head will be the part of speech of the whole compound. For example, here dark room is one compound which comes under endocentric compounds, because this is because it is denoting a special kind of a room, which is a dark room. As we can say that part of speech of room is noun, so part of speech of whole compound, that is dark room, will also be noun. It is also important to know the Sanskrit word for endocentric compounds or all the types of compounds, as we will be focusing on NET exam. So endocentric compounds in Sanskrit are known as Tatpurush Samas. Also in English it can be written as Tatpurusa. Now in contrary to endocentric compounds, we have exocentric compounds, where A plus B doesn't denote any special kind of B, but A plus B is something very different, means neither it denotes A nor it denotes B. And as endocentric were semantically headed compounds, exocentric are semantically non-headed compounds. Here compounds parts of speech will not be determined by that of head, but it will be inferred lexically. A Sanskrit name for exocentric compounds are Bahuvirya Samas. Okay, let's just now discuss the example for exocentric compound. We have an exocentric compound pickpocket. Here pickpocket is not denoting any special kind of a pocket, but it is denoting something else, and that pickpocket is a person who steals from the pocket of others. So it is something very exocentric, very outside the word. Now another distinction is made between copulative compounds and appositional compounds. So copulative compound, as copulative means coordinative, means it is the sum of something. So here the compound AB is the sum of A and B, means it is A plus B. So as there is no modifier here, so we have two semantic heads which are present in this copulative compounds. In Sanskrit, this compound is known as Dand Samas. For example, we have the compound bitter sweet. So it is a copulation, or it is a coordination of bitter and sweet. Similarly goes with actor and manager. Now coming to appositional compounds. Appositional compounds are compounds which gives different attributes for same different. Means we have this example, maid servant. So we are referring to a maid who is a servant. Means we are referring to a single referent here, but we are giving that referent different attributes. Means we have given that maid attribute also and servant attribute also. Similarly, it goes with actor director. Here also we are talking about an actor who is a director. Okay, so we are again giving it different attributes, but the referent is the same. It is important to know that, as I told you, that Sanskrit name of these compounds also. So apositional compounds is known as Karmdhare Samas in Sanskrit. I hope this video will be helpful for the upcoming exam. Do share the video. Thank you.